So I think there are two main challenges that we need to keep our eye on. And the first, I think, comes from this general repeal of responsible regulation to protect consumers. And I think, you know, Acting Director Mulvaney, who previously led the Bureau, removed considerable protections across a number of important sort of key markets, whether it's student loan protections that he walked back, mortgage reporting callbacks, payday lending. So across all fronts, there's been a massive just sort of pull the carpet from under the feet of consumers that we need to correct immediately. But I do think that we, in correcting and righting that ship, there's an opportunity here to think more clearly about what systems we replace with what Dr. Mulvaney took down. So, for example, I think with the widespread use of machine learning is really going to present some key challenges for us. I see that, you know, more and more, whether it's fintechs or Facebook or Google, there's a blurring of the lines between, for example, marketing, how we encourage consumers to reach out and join the financial services market, and then how do those interactions with financial services institutions, non-bank and bank, translate to credit rationing processes. So there's a new study out from the University of California, Berkeley, that showed that even with fintech and all these brand new algorithmic decision scoring models, there's still a fair amount of pricing discrimination in the market. And African Americans and Latinos continue to bear the brunt of this cost imbalance. Between 5.6 and 8.6 percentage basis points higher, they're charged than their non-Hispanic white counterparts. And that's hundreds of millions of dollars in the pockets of financial institutions, and that's sort of extracted from these consumers who tend to be the most vulnerable. However, what they did find, I think that was most interesting, is that lending discrimination when it comes to who gets loans and who gets approved versus denied, it declined significantly. And I think that's a bright spot. But I wonder what's the true source of that bright spot. Is it because in the marketing space, companies can now target who they want to encourage applications from? And so the denominator looks artificially smaller, and therefore origination disparities don't look too concerning. There's a lot of, I think, blurring, and that we need to sort of really disentangle what's going on. I'm just going to add one last thing. I think we need to sort of think about how FTC and CFPB really connect and sort of come closer together in how they protect consumers. There's this big gulf between these two agencies and between data challenges, whether it's cookies that are tracking you all over the internet that provide a wealth of information for companies to turn into lead generators. CFPB doesn't have a lot of jurisdiction in that area, so we really need to bring these two agencies together, borrow some stuff from the GDPR in Europe to really put our consumer protection framework back together.